Hey, and we're back. Welcome to Game 9 Analysis for the Middle Age Road to 2200 series we got going on. Game 9, if you saw, it was pretty cool. Couple pivotal moments for mistakes. And what's nice is that I identified the mid-game. So we're going to chew through that with this analysis in depth. No engine to start, kind of chew through our own ideas, then check it with an engine, and finally look at the chess.com performance review. So one thing to note about this game, let's flip it here. One thing to note about this game is I don't have a solid repertoire for d4 as black. I have toyed with Chebanenko Slav, I've toyed with like a reversed London, I've toyed with the Dutch, probably the longest, and I toyed with e6, b6, then I started trying to do Slav stuff of every kind, and now in this game, not really knowing what I wanted to do, I tried to go to the e6, b6 setup, which kind of goes into Dutch territory, which I am sort of familiar with, but never have played well with. So I make this decision, and it kind of plays standard to this point. So this is a very classic setup for the e6, b6, and it basically turns into a type of Dutch, except in a Dutch, usually this gets pushed right away in the first two moves, and then the knight goes behind, and the bishop usually goes here or there in the Dutch. Shout out to Gotham, of course. He's famous for, he has a course on this, and I've seen a bit of it. Like, when I say I've seen a bit of it, 15 minutes total. So, that being said, we're here, and then I knew that the move was to push f5, and I'm officially out of what I know here. In the game, I made a mistake, and I identified it mid-game, and luckily my opponent did not punish me for my mistake. So right here, when he pushed here, this is the moment. And I took mistake. See, the thinking is a guy wants to go like this, 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 this. Right? You can't block with the pawn. White steps out of the way. I guess that's the move I was thinking of, the sequence, right? Winning the bishop with the check and getting it back for this pawn. Now, it will not go that way with best play, though. So, after I capture this pawn, and he captures here, and I capture here, he can hit me with this. And when I move out of the way, computer hates that. I guess computer wants me to go here? No. Huh. I wonder what the computer wants. Computer wants G6. I tried that. But then, yeah, okay, that makes sense. I guess it's not that scary. Yeah, I guess it's not that scary, eh? Well, at any rate, it's kind of interesting to look at that. So maybe I could have got away with it. He takes, I take. Bishop takes. So they want this taken first, this taken. Queen h4 check. King d2. And I take. So I guess I could have gotten away with it, hey? And that's kind of the territory we ended up in. Computer says it's a mistake, though, because of F takes. Then you just trade everything off. Yeah, okay. No, I was right. Queen h5, g6, Queen e5. Oh, what? Really? Oh, going after the rook. Oh, it's a double attack. Nice. That's what the computer sees here. So the computer sees this double attack on my bishop and my rook. I did not see that. Wow. So that's why, if you go back and follow it, that is why taking is a mistake. And I knew it was a mistake because of this check. I didn't see it through to the double attack on the bishop and the rook. Ouch. So yeah, definite mistake. So turning the engine off, what I think needs to be played here was my first gut reaction of this. Only move is to block, well, most likely move. And then you go back here, targeting this pawn. The knight can't move. And if he takes, honestly, you could even, if he takes, I could develop the knight here. He could even get greedy. I could castle. He could get. And I looked at this line post game in the original video, and with rooks coming down to this file, this pawn being bombarded by three different pieces, this still having a pin on, I mean, the king is in major trouble, I think. So, note to self, I gotta look at this more carefully, but I believe after this, I mean, maybe it is fine to take and trade everything off, like we saw, but I think that the check is even better. So, something that I'm gonna have to look deeper into. But my opponent made a mistake, I feel. He took with the bishop. And I took, and I mean, he decided to move his king. I took a pawn. Now I knew that he wanted this, but I knew I could always get out with a check. And I thought this pawn could get soft if I go here. I kind of missed his queen would also join the fight in defending it. So I kind of missed that, but I decided this also gives me opportunities to castle queen side. So I got out a check. And then it's at this point where I wish I could have taken that, but I couldn't. And I made a big decision here. I mean, I wanted to develop, but this worried me. This is coming. So I check the king again to obviously get my queen out of danger. And then I decided to develop the knight so that I could get more development. And I decided to trade queens, trade bishop, and castle queenside. Now, my big worry was this push. Because let's just look at it here. If he pushed, and I take, he takes, I could take this with check, which is the key, and then I could go back. So that is kind of like what I thought would be okay now that I'm castled. But if you go back, right here, I thought about pushing this to stop this. And now if he pushes it, I don't have that option. So this is where the castling came in. But I really thought he was gonna go there, and he went there. I think that was a poor choice for the square. And now I decide to do my second mistake of the game. You'll see mid-game. I so wanted to command the center and stop this that I forgot about this pawn. I completely forgot about it when I decided to push this. What am I thinking? So unfortunately, I lost a pawn. Now I took it back, but now this pawn can be taken at any time. My opponent did not choose to do that. He decided to finally utilize this pin, which is smart. I step out of the pin, which is smart. Now I figure he's gonna come over here and put pressure on this knight. But I always have the check to get out of danger. So he traded. Again, I don't know if that was right. I have to take back with the knight, obviously, or else if I take, he takes. I take. Then he takes the pawn. And I decide to just put pressure down this file. And I jump out of the way with plans of coming here. I had plans to go there. At this point, let's say with good play that, I mean, I don't know. What if he attacks my knight? Probably not the best move. Maybe expand. At this point, I think I was gonna make an improvement move. Something like this. But this is where the tide of the game changed for me indeed. He went there. I mean, for any viewer there that's starting at chess and interested in content, I know you can see the move here, and maybe we shouldn't show that. But there's a tactic here. And unfortunately, he missed it. So, sayonara, goodbye. He tried to go after the rook. I blocked. I got a check in and then stopped this file, and my opponent resigned. Solid win, but it could have went very poorly for me. Now, turning on the lines again here. Computer's top move is Queen H4 check, which was out of my first gut instinct. It says F takes is fine too. Both are very close. It likes Queen H4 a little more. I mean, maybe I can explore this idea. Bishop takes c3, trade it all off. Commuter says knight f6, but it's a 0.6 advantage, 1.1 for white. So I think already that f takes, even though it's the second computer rated line, I think it's a no-go. I don't like it. So queen h4 check. Here, step back. E takes f5. Knight to c6, eh? Knight f6. Now, if f takes e, castle. Bishop e2. Trying to set up this, maybe? D takes E. Yeah. This is an interesting chess game. These bishops are kind of annoying, but... Yeah, bishops don't move like that. Yeah, these bishops are kind of annoying. A3, eh? Queen D3. See, now in this line, it's black who has a 0.5, 0.6 advantage. So I like this much better. So I have to remember this, the queen check idea. Moving along. Did I play this right? Queen takes e4, yep. Knight c6 was the top move, I like that. Now, obviously queen g4. It wants queen g4. I went to f4 check, and that's the fourth recommended computer line. Now it wants f5, check, which I did. Knight g to e7, second computer recommended line. Queen takes, check. Bishop takes c3. So these were all top moves. Castle queenside was third, second, fighting. The computer's fighting. Second recommended. It wanted me to castle this way. Hey, that looked scary to me with him just being able to chase down these pawns. So he played there. So right here, I should have just took an open file. Right? It wants one of these two rooks to the open file. That's exactly what I should have done. Instead, I blundered. D takes c4 is the top computer. Oh yeah, it switched there. Let's give it some time. Okay, it's the second recommended computer line. D takes c4. King takes c4, but he went here. Rook d7. So, oh my god, there's an idea here that I was gonna go for and didn't. I talked about it in the game. The check takes check. But then, after he could go to b5... right? He could go to b5 or he could go to d3. And then I thought, okay, let's say he goes d3, h6. Why would I do that? Oh, the fork. Yeah, I guess I could have made some progress there. Could have got away with that. I don't know if I like it. Computers. So what I saw, you know, I was hoping to get a check out of this little maneuver. I saw this whole idea. And then I thought, oh, am I going to go here? And that just helps his rook develop. And I was like, eh. So I decided not to go for the check right away. I decided to defend the knight first, and then I was going to go for the check. So that's what I did. Then he took. Yeah. Pretty much standard stuff after that. So let's look at the review. 87%. What was my one miss? This ignores an opportunity to threaten winning a pawn by going there instead. Yeah, because then I threaten this with check. It wants me to give the knight up. How is that good? Oh. Discover check. Ouch. That's on the queen. Oh, that's gnarly. Nice little castling queenside tactic there to d5. And this attacking this, I like that. Okay. That was a nice little nugget. Okay, well that was my miss. What are my two mistakes? Oh, that's obvious. Yeah, that's obvious mistake. And what's my next mistake? Hanging the pawn? Yeah. This loses a pawn. Okay, well, 87% and the W in a crazy E6, B6 / Dutch. We take those. Opening, 88% accuracy, 86 in the middle game, and there was no end game. Well, that was another W. Hope you enjoyed the analysis and stay tuned for when we hit the double digits, game 10. Until next time, cheers.